Now I invite our last speaker, Mr. Aditya Singhania from Navitaas.
Good morning, everyone. I am Aditya Singhania. I think we are getting late with the presentations. Today I will speak only for about 2 minutes. What we are actually doing at the moment, I think you know that we are a solar module manufacturer, but it's all been talked about at a great length in the last 2-3 years. So now our main aim in the technology sector at the moment is developing new ways to integrate multiple nodes of generation. You can always develop solar panels, you can always develop high efficiency solar panel, you can always develop storage systems. But what we need at the moment is how you manage all that power and the generation and the consumption of all that power. So we are currently in research and development stage for the system that can analyze the power being generated, that can monitor the consumption, and that can instruct instruments and home appliances into consuming the power when the power is free or you have surplus generation at the moment. So we are currently working on that. This will obviously address many problems that can come with grid applications, that is meeting the peak demands and synchronizing and management of multiple feeding and consumption points. So this is what we are doing at the moment. Maybe I can give you more information on this within a couple of months or about 6 months. Thank you.
That was very short, Aditya. Thank you very much. Now, you know, before we open for a question and answer, I just have would like to request all the members here who are present to just be brief in your question, and please avoid repeating those questions. Please introduce yourself first before you ask question, and the question is for whom, that also you just need to tell. So any questions from the audience? We have maximum 10 minutes to wrap up, so yeah. Mic, please. It's on, working, you can just speak.
My question is not for a specific one, but it's for general. Speaker told regarding the policy, sir, that there should be improvement of policy, link policy, agreed, sir. But our renewable energy comes in picture from 2010, I think so. So, policy before right now, this is my question, sir. Second one, regarding the free hand in the solar, sir. What do you mean by free hand? There should not be any control from government or public oriented. Thank you, sir.
Patil sir, would you like to answer this?
Mr. Chetan, while doing the moderation only a moment ago, very rightly said what he quoted of Mr. Narayan Murthy.
Can you just speak a little closer? Yeah.
This conference has covered almost all spectrums of renewable energy, including from land to social development to technology and policies and all. We also talked of the dipping prices of the solar modules and the renewable sector per se. Before you ask this question, I was just talking to Mr. Munjal that with the falling prices, and if there is no need to repeat saying that we need to go for solar because it has been very well proven. And I also feel that there should be minimum interference from the government if the product can sell on its own, which has happened in other cases also, for example, solar water heating systems. We started with a good amount of 50-60% subsidy, which was gradually reduced, and now they are selling on their own. So The government can intervene only in the initial stages when it has to be put on a path, and once it's taken off, I think minimum intervention would help the industries to go. Thank you.
My question is that regarding the intervention from the government regarding the price and other things, government should not have any binding on the manufacturer. You mean that?
You mean the pricing should be controlled by the government? That's what you're trying to say?
For the help of poor Indian, it should be controlled by government.
I don't really follow your question. If we look the trend of the renewable energy, this solar industry which started in India in mega scale in 2009-10, we saw a price of 18 crores rupees a megawatt. And now we are talking of less than 4 crores rupees a megawatt. So these are the market forces which have brought down the prices. Only that the government helped in giving a very tall order of the capacities to be added, which probably led to the market development, and the market forces themselves are deciding prices. If you look at the bids, last bids of the solar and wind, that also it's a testimony of the market forces playing a very big role in that.
Yeah, driven by market forces, agreed, sir. Regarding the policy, sir.
Yes.
Policy that our that solar energy or renewable energy comes into picture from 2010, sir. So that policy from before that one, yeah, right one, because depends on the government, sir. Right now, government from BJP, that was government of from Congress and others. That's why I'm asking.
I think I'll give him a break and take this one. See, how did everything start? Because we realized that renewable energy is good for us. That's how the wind started. Now, nobody was paying, no private player was paying for wind energy for 12, 14 crores, or no private player willing to pay 18 crore, as sir mentioned. So government said, you know what, let us give us a hand. Let me give you a very good government company can give you NVVN 18 rupees so you can invest 18 crore. So I think government plays enabling role, which they have done. How to regulate the market, it is going to be very difficult for government to do it. And the free market has to decide who are the good guys, who are the bad guys, who is it competitive, technologically advanced guys who can deliver on the promise. But if in general we ask for more intervention, we get more trouble, no matter whose government it is.
Yeah, another question.
Just to add to what he was asking, specifically to poor people, the policy of Government of India and state governments has helped the development of solar. For example, 10-15 years back, home indoor lighting systems or lanterns, we have sold millions of them, lakhs of them through subsidy scheme. We had to collect the ID proof of ration card or something like that, and we have sold. So definitely government has done its bit of developing the market, definitely. And now it's on its own. For home lighting, I don't think there is any subsidy. And today there are so many manufacturers of lanterns, you know, with LED lamps. The market has developed, technology has developed. Surely it is helping.
Yeah, in fact, I think there is another question which has cropped up here, which is like, you know, everybody is, these days, globally, people are talking about the falling price of new tenders which are coming in. Do you think, Mr. Munjal, that 2.44 is actually a result of falling equipment prices, or it is just a financial gain?
That's on my mind also. I think as Mr. this new government opened up from a 20 gigawatt to 100 gigawatt, the whole market, entire world came into India saying we want to invest. So yes, it's the history says that from 2008 to 2017 May, prices have been falling because the supply is outnumbered demand by 4 times. So yes, there is a general trend. So people took that trend as literally, number one. Number two, the financial, solar has been not a technological game, has been a business model game. So in India, we invest, we expect 14% margin return or on our investment. When the outside investors came, you know, they said, you know what, 9% is okay with me. So if you look at the last 1 year winning results, except Acme, every other entity has been an international company where their expectation is much different than ours. So it's a combination of both. And the third will be the wild card, will be how ambitious you are and how risk taker you are. So these are the three factors which takes it to that. And once you have money, for international guys, if you have $1 billion, they have to spend $1 billion. Yeah. So it's a risk ability that goes up.
Any other panelists want to contribute on this?
International investors are more intelligent when they are investing money in Indian market. They have certainly return expectation, even if INR return expectation may be for Indian players 14-15, but they expect a dollar return, which would translate if we consider the hedge cost in little lower 4-5%. So they also expect a healthy return, and it's not that tariff number were arrived completely on basis of the falling trend and speculation. These are more intelligent players who might have done their math before doing it. It's not India. I mean, we are far behind 2 cents even now. And it's not only now UAE, it's Chile, Mexico, everywhere the tenders are, where large utilities, Europe, and I'm talking European utilities, NL, NG, they are quoting less than 2 cents. So it cannot be that India is a very different market in terms of tariff. Of course, module price have seen a current trend, but we all know polysilicon alone is not the contributor for that cost going upwards. The contributors could be the 201 case in US, could be the demand supply, domestic demand more in China. So let's see in Q3 2018 also if this thing is because of the raw material or just because of demand supply.
Yeah, in fact, there are international players and they are experienced players. They are financial, large financial institutions also. Yeah, they are when they are involved, particularly when the entry of SoftBank in India. So basically, you know, but I do not know. I mean, I have my own doubts. It's my personal view, but I have my own doubts that whether they have actually calculated all the surprises that they are going to face in India, because international market there are less number of surprises because there is a clarity. But when it comes to India, at the ground realities are, you know, like you have a 10 considerations, and but when you actually start working on it, you might have another 10 surprises. So India is looking forward to have such projects at this price, and you know, that will really bring a lot of opportunity for everybody in this, because, you know, sometimes falling prices, people says no, business is gone now, but it's not that. Business will grow when the prices prices goes down. So I think we must look forward. Yeah, so any questions from the audience now?
Hello.
Yeah,
I am Kirti Joshi from Adani Greens. My question is to Mr. Kapil Maheshwari regarding the storage, particularly linking the PV to EV. EV will provide the distributed storage instead of going bulk storage. It is the better option to create the storages. So why we should promote the EV with parallel to the solar industry? And what is the present trend in India to link the PV to EV with supporting by tariffs, hourly basis tariff, if the all EVs are being charged in daytime with a different hourly tariffs, it will provide the better option of the storage. So what is going in India for this storage option?
Good question. Storage at the moment for charging electric vehicle, the policy is still in a framework. So they're coming out with the draft policies already out from ESL. I feel that electric vehicles will drive the storage market in India. I mean, if we talk of a total market size in by 2022 of around 180 to 200 gigawatt, which are the estimates from various leading consultants on the EV market, more than 50 to 60% of it would come from electric vehicle. One good way to look, and which has been globally adopted as well, that the same batteries, which because the battery life is defined that after 80% of achieving it, and then it's not useful in the electric vehicle. So it can have a second life in the stationary storage, where it can be in combination with solar and storage, as well as the utility scale, because that is still a good amount of lifetime of 10, 12 years is left in that battery, which may not be used in an electric vehicle, but can be used as in storage along with solar. And certainly the until fast charging mechanisms come, EV charging through solar would still remain a question, because with only with solar, it's very hard to assume that you will be able to achieve in fast charging. I mean, the amount of current you can draw from a solar system would always be a limitation what current a panel can supply. And you cannot pump in so much of current to charge your vehicle, which has a battery of 30 kilowatt, to charge it in 15 minutes. So you need in support from the grid, even if you have a solar system installed. Partially it can do that, but certainly on microgrids, telecom towers where the current requirements is less, and you can, you know, charge those battery for a longer duration. But it certainly has an application through solar, where I feel that if you want to set it up in hotels, if you want to set it up in IT SEZs, where an employee come, park his car, work for the entire day, and that time he can charge his car and then go back home. So there, such application, it has a lot of potential. But during daytime, in a slow charging, you're charging it through solar panels. I hope I answer.
Thank you. As I mentioned earlier, like Gujarat was a pioneer in utility scale projects. And Gujarat is a pioneer in rooftop also, because we work pan-India and we have seen other states. There are many states, they are still thinking whether to do it or not. And Gujarat has done so much in residential rooftop. I think, you know, that is something which is really amazing thing which has happened. And the best part is, in spite of having so much here, you know, the Gujarat as a government, as a GEDA, as a nodal agency, I think, you know, they are continuously improving the process to minimize the time and increase the efficiency. So I think, you know, the first thing is, you know, the result, I mean, why this has happened. According to my experience, because the GEDA has ears. Normally government agency don't have ears. You know, they are not ready to listen anything. But I think the way the GEDA is conducting meetings with the system integrators frequently and taking inputs, I think they really deserve a big round of applause. So I just wanted to ask Mr. Patil, it's the last question of this session, that what is your, like, the journey of Gujarat rooftop? What is your experience? Like, you know, do you think that you are satisfied with this?
First of all, Mr. Chetan, thank you for the compliments that you have given to GEDA. The rooftop journey, we didn't start with the residential one. We started way back in 2006-07. Even when the net metering policy was not there, or even the Gujarat government policy was not there, But to promote the use of solar energy, we started installation of rooftops in government buildings. And we did so, and we are continuing to do so even now. Just to share you that probably by today, yesterday we had reached about 99 point some megawatts in the rooftop sector, and surely today we would have crossed 100 megawatt. This 100 megawatt comes from almost 25 megawatt from the residential sector, 25 megawatt from industry sector, about 6 megawatt from commercial, and the balance from the social sector like the trusts and the government sector. Government is closely about 23 megawatt. The journey has been quite experienced and challenges to be faced, but I think we have been trying to overcome all these challenges through. To tell you of the domestic solar rooftop, the timelines have been continuously trying to be reduced. Earlier we had a 90 days timeline, which was reduced to almost 30 days. Now with little more, we are further trying to do it with the least interventions, or to for the ease of doing business, we are trying to do it. Of course, there is a lot of scope still to do it. There is ample scope, as rightly said, that the against the target of 175 gigawatt, the share of Gujarat is 8,000 megawatt, of which 40% should come from rooftop, that is about 3,200 megawatt, and we have reached little over 100, so there is a long way to go. And it won't happen only with the efforts of the governments, it would be the efforts of all of you, the common man, all the sector people, and the government can always do the hand holding and can issue requisite guidelines for taking further this cause, so that by the year 2022 or even before that, we try to reach there, and with the competitive market, I don't think that target is unachievable, so we should be able to do that. Thank you so much.
Any closing remark from any of the panelists? Thank you very much, and I really am thankful to all the panelists here for sharing their views, and audience also, and a special thanks to Anand, and we look forward to have more sessions like this in future, and I'm sure this kind of initiative will definitely will help Gujarat as a state and India as a nation to achieve the targets. Thank you very much. Thank you all.
Thank you very much, sir. And my special thanks to all the panelists for enlightening all of us this morning. Moving on, may I request our session chair and moderator, Chetan sir, to present a small mementos to all the panelists, please.